Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you how to make a transparent stroke on an object or live type in Adobe Illustrator. And the way we'll do this is with something called knockout group. So here's an example of what I mean. We've got a transparent stroke, and then here we've got a transparent fill. Now I want to say that if you're going to print this or if you want to use it for screen printing or something like that, you might not have great success with that. So you'll probably have to take a few extra steps to expand it and knock out the areas. But it's really great because it's non-destructive. So if you need to keep your text typable, maybe you want to change the font in the future, or if you want to keep your shapes so they're whole and not, you know, cut apart with a pathfinder, this is a great way to do it. All right, let's get started. All right, so I've created this kind of background so you can kind of see how it works. So now I'm going to type my word. I'm just going to type hello, and I'm gonna change this to a kind of bold script so you can really see the effect well. I'll make it a little bit bigger. Whoa, but not that big. And then I'll click on type in my appearance panel. Your appearance panel is under window, and all the other panels you see here are also under window if you need them. So I'm going to add a new fill. Now I'm also going to go in my characters and get rid of the fill here. Okay, so now we just have one fill. I'm going to duplicate this fill by clicking over here in the empty space and holding Alt or Option until I get a blue line. And this will make a copy of that fill. Now the first fill, I want the opacity to be 0%. And then the second fill, I think I'll make this one pink. This one is going to be offset. So to do that, I'll come up here to Effect, Path, and Offset Path. And I think 10 point is good. So we'll say okay. I'm gonna go ahead and put my opacity back. That looks pretty good, so I'll put my opacity back at 0 now. Now I'm going to come down here all the way to the bottom and click opacity here under characters, and I'll choose knockout group. Now if you just click it once, nothing will happen. You'll need to click it twice to get a check mark. And now this fill is transparent. It just looks like white now, but let's move it over the background. And you can see the background showing through. Let's go ahead and change our bottom fill color to white. And we'll make this a little bit smaller. Now let's make a copy of this, and I'll show you how to make a stroke that's transparent. First, we'll need to select the background and the word, holding Shift, and group those together with Command-G or Control-G. Then use your group selection tool to select just the word itself. And now I'm going to change this fill to 100%. Now I say stroke, but this is actually an offset path. I'll put the opacity here at 0. Then I'm going to select the whole group, and we'll change the group's opacity to a knockout group. Again, you'll have to click it a couple times until you get the check mark. And if we want to make changes to how thick the stroke is, we can do that by just getting on the group selection, selecting the live text, and changing the offset path to maybe something more like this. So if you want a transparent fill, you don't need it to be grouped to the background, but if you want a transparent stroke, you will need that group because otherwise Illustrator doesn't know what to knock out, if that makes sense. All right, if you like this video and you want to see more videos like this, just hit the subscribe button and the little bell next to it and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.